are you? What are you doing?
There's a golf links going in here.
What's golf?
Golf is a game played by gentlemen. Not for the likes of you. Now, run along, boy.
This is how we do, Francis.
You work hard,
and you bring all the money.
Work hard, bring all the money.
Thank you. Francis, what in the world are you doing? It's after midnight. You're keeping your brother up. Go to bed. Raina, go to sleep. No talking. No noises. We mean it.
What have you got here, Francis? Hmm?
Francis.
Can I see him, Father? Please?
What's he talking about? See who?
Harry Vardy.
The gentleman who plays this game is not a friend to you.
I know. But he's the greatest ever.
Arthur, I don't see the harm in him.
Not another word. The boy goes to school today. It's the end of it.
Francis, leave your books. I've got shopping to do. You come with me now.
But Father said I have to go to school.
Well, then you can miss school for one day. Besides, I need help with my packages. Come along.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I now presume upon your goodwill and request the services of a volunteer. Anyone? Oh! Hello. What's your name?
Francis.
Hello, Mr. Francis. Now, do you know what this is?
Brassy.
So it is. Have a bash. That's all right, Francis. Even in our darkest hour, we must always remember. You never despair. You held a lifeboat in your hands.
Not too hard to hurt it. Just firm enough to stop it from flying away. Try it again.
Conquering hero.
Mr. Darling? Is this what I think it is?
I'm not sure, Harry. I received the summons from Lord Northcliffe, just as you did.
Keep the change, mate.
He's waiting inside.
Today's the day.
But, Harry, no professional has ever been asked to join a gentleman's golf club as a member.
First time for everything, Bernard.
Yes.
Look at this place. Why else would they want you here? Afternoon?
He doesn't confide in me. I only work for him.
10 years ago, I was clipping hedges.
Brilliantly done, Harry.
Thanks, sir.
I'd be honored if you gentlemen would consider adding it to your trophy case.
A glittering addition. We'd be pleased to keep it for you, wouldn't we, Neville?
Handsome. But you might not get it back without a tussle.
Don't plan on handing it back myself without a bit of a fight, sir.
Harry, I'll come right to the point. We've had an opening at our club. Lord Bullock chairs the membership committee.
What does your father do?
He's a gardener on Jersey, sir.
I'm told you're Church of Rome. Mother's French?
Yes, sir.
I believe we can work around it.
We've decided then. You're just the man for us.
I don't know what to say, sir.
We'll say yes. We want you to work for us. Decent wage. You can run your own shop. Lessons, of course. Charge what you like for those.
You're the only man in England who can set me right.
You'll have your work cut out. I think it's drinks all round.
I'm told you to work for
it. Golf is a game played by gentlemen.
Not for the likes of you.
Played by gentlemen.
Run your own shop. Decent wage.
Run along, boy.
Francis, it's after midnight.
Just one more, Mother.
Mr. Hastings!
Ah, Master Francis.
Sure.
We now lack but one essential to complete the swift appointment of our round. Your clubs.
My clubs, sir. Caddies aren't allowed on the course. If Mr. Campbell sees me out
there...
Let
me worry about Campbell. Go, get those clubs. You go, boy, get those clubs. Up, 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 up!
What did you shoot?
An 81, sir.
What did you take on 15?
A 9, sir.
So you shot an 81 first time around on the toughest golf course in New England with a 9.
Well, I saw you standing there, knowing the caddies aren't supposed to play.
Go on.
I think I got a little nervous, sir.
We needed to see how you handled yourself.
Handle myself.
National Amateur Championships here next month.
Are you saying that I can... What do I have to do? I'll do anything.
You have to play in the qualifier.
That's the easy part. First, you have to be approved by the executive committee.
You're a caddy here?
Yes, sir. For 10 years. I just recently resigned to preserve my status as an amateur.
What? No plans to turn professional?
No, sir. I plan to have a career in business.
Oh, business?
Yes. What sort of business?
Sorry. Carry on. What's your home club? I don't see it here. They have to sponsor you.
My home club. I'm between clubs at the moment.
Look, see here. You may have qualified as a player, but this just isn't the sort of thing the caddies do.
You're a caddy.
Yes, sir, I was.
Caddies don't play in the amateur. It's not for your kind. Members only. We need to discuss the opening of the Greens Committee.
I'm sorry, but there must be a way for somebody who's not a member to compete.
Not this year. If he could afford the $50 entrance fee.
Excuse me, sir. If I were to pay the $50, would I still need to belong to a club?
No, technically, no.
Look, you would still need a club member in good standing to sponsor you.
And that would be me.
$50 to play golf.
I'll pay back every penny for my earnings.
Is this how I failed you, Francis? Is that all you've learned from me?
No, sir, but it's just a game.
A game? Game doesn't give a man what he needs to make a life, feed his family.
Yes, but if I win, great things can happen.
Nothing will happen. They'll use you for their own amusement.
I can do this. This is something I'm good at.
What if you do? What will you get for your $50? I had dreams too, Francis. No matter what you do, they'll never let you cross that street.
All I want is a chance.
Okay, we make a bargain. You promise me, if you lose, no more golf. You give up this fool's game. You finish your schooling, you learn a trade, and you bring home an honest wage.
If I don't qualify. Yes, I promise.
The English edition is not even in print here yet.
Harry Varden. Thank you.
Read it. Study it. You'll need a 78 to qualify. It's different competition. These are the best amateurs in the country.
You think I'm ready?
I don't know, and neither will you until you're in it. It's golf, and it's championship golf.
Keep it for me. I'm going to the party. I said all the players are invited. What's it like in there?
I couldn't tell you. I'm not allowed inside.
I used to see before I left for college is after me. But pretend you asked me to dance.
There you are, you little peach. You know, you can't avoid me all evening.
I said a dance, Philip. Not this one. I promised this one to...
Francis, we met. Do I know your family?
I don't know. Philip Wainwright?
Wainwright. Oh, yes, Wainwright. Good people. Wainwright. Well, the evening's young. Should catch up with you.
You're a real sport for helping.
Oh, it's no trouble. I had the craziest day. So I take a train home from Philadelphia. My bags end up in Baltimore. My tux is in the bags in Baltimore. I'm wearing the houseman suit.
I think you look just fine.
You too.
Is he gone?
No, he's still watching. Can we dance? You said you're going to college?
Smith. First semester.
Oh.
Where are you going? To college.
Oh, I'm taking the year off to consider my options.
I think that's so wise. Perhaps you'll go to Europe.
Perhaps I will, because I have family in France.
I'm sorry. What did you say your name was again?
Francis. We met.
Oh, look, there's my brother. Freddie, you must know Francis.
Freddie? Catty boy? Freddie, you're such a kidder.
Dad, Mother, this is Francis we met.
How do you do? That's a beautiful dress.
Francis is playing in the tournament.
Yes, I know.
Will you boys chat? Mother and I will be right back.
Swell girl, your daughter.
Young man, you may have been invited, but don't get the idea that you belong here.
Thank you.
only two types of player. Those who keep their nerves in control and win championships, and those who do not.
Five or less, and you make the cut.
18? I can make 5 here in my sleep. It's too bad, caddy boy. You could caddy for me in the tournament. You're available, right? Congratulations, son. Well played. Empire, Harry. Sun never sets on us, all that rubbish. Consider the glory that was Greece of Alexander the Great. Now you can't even find it on a map. Greece introduced sport to the world, pure expression of their superiority. We've trodden that same road. Football, cricket, rugby, golf, all the major championships remain in British hands. Save one. The U.S. Open. You won it before. I want you to mount a new campaign. To do to the Americans what Alexander did to the Persians. Lay waste to them. My papers get exclusive coverage. Bernard here comes along to chronicle your conquest. It's our game, man. Win that Open and bring back that trophy. You pocket your winnings, of course.
You need to pay for the crossing, sir.
All expenses paid. As part of an exhibition tour, all sponsors arranged. Does that cover it? Yep, that'd do it. And I hear there's talk of an honorary membership at the club. This would clinch it. I dare say His Majesty might want to show his gratitude to England's greatest sportsman, Harry Vardon, Order of the British Empire. Has a nice ring to it. We'll need a partner, someone to share the workload with. My thoughts exactly. Young Wilfred here's your man, top amateur in the British Isles. Delighted, old chap. Jolly good wheeze, what?
Giving the Yanks a thorough thrashing.
I had someone else in mind.
Ted Ray? Christ, isn't this a goal?
No, he's a Jersey man. Excuse me.
Entirely mine. What brings you down this way, Harry?
Hello, hello. Stop getting so gay. Don't you think you're ways you want to be?
They moved the open back 3 whole months just so one guy can play in it.
Well, he's Harry Vardon, the stylist, the greyhound.
Hey, I don't care if he's the man in the moon. They wouldn't do that for an American. That's Francis. He used to play.
You did?
No, not really. Yeah, he's being modest. He used to be pretty good before he gave it up for the glamour of retail. Isn't that right, Francis? Francis! Francis!
Casey would waltz with the strawberry blonde, and the band played on. He'd lie cross the floor with the girl he adored, and the band played on. His brain was so loaded, it nearly exploded. The poor girl would shake with alarm. He'd ne'er leave a girl with a strawberry curl, and the band played.
Glorious. Wasn't it glorious?
Yes, it was.
Have you ever heard such a voice?
It was like the music was coming through her from someplace else. That's the feeling I've always wanted.
This is for what?
Thank you.
Francis, come here. I'd like you to meet Robert Watson, president of the United States Golf Association.
Francis, pleasure. Well, pleasure's mine, sir. Yes, well, let me have a salesman show you our equipment. It's the best selection in Boston.
He's not here to buy clubs, lad.
I hear you live in Brookline, not far from the country club.
Right across the street.
We're holding our open championship there in 2 weeks. Your name came up.
My name, sir?
I'm looking to add a local amateur to the field.
Harry Varden's playing. And Ted Ray.
Mr. Watson, thank you. But I can't accept.
Why not?
I'm awfully busy here. I don't play golf anymore.
How old are you, Francis?
I'm 20, sir.
Awfully young to be giving up on your dreams, aren't you, son?
Well, I just have different ones now, that's all. Sorry, Mr. Hastings.
There's no need to explain, Francis. All the best.
That swing looks familiar.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Father's taking me out for our annual round. My brother said that you were working here.
Your brother? I've seen him in here a couple times.
I was hoping you could sell me some equipment.
I'm not actually a salesman.
Still considering your options?
Yeah. I'll get you a salesman.
Harry Varden, the stylist. Practice round.
We're expecting a big turnout, so it's important we have marshals at this gate, here,
Mr. Watson,
and here.
Francis Rumet, can I speak to you for a moment, sir?
Yes, what is it?
Well, if that offer playing the open is still good, sir, I'd love to take you up on it.
I'm busy here. We have to think about that.
Well, not ask for any favors, sir.
Can you give us a moment, Francis? What about Grove Street?
Yeah, man, yes.
Leave me here. Sun up. You got some work to do.
Where do we stand?
Cut line 76. Six holes to make up 4 shots.
You just made 6 straight birdies.
I did?
Congratulations, lad. You're in the open.
Gentlemen, I want to welcome you all, professionals and amateurs alike, to the 18th United States Open Championship. Four rounds of golf will be played over the next 2 days to identify the best player in the world. Let's give a special welcome to the British amateur champion, Mr. Wilfred Reed. And our favorite professional visitors, Harry Vardon and Ted Ray. I'll yield the floor to our defending champion, professional from Philadelphia, John McDermott.
If you read the papers, you know there's a lot of talk about the great English champion sailing over here to play in our Open. As the only born American to ever win this cup, I'd like to say to you boys, welcome. We're happy to have you. We all know Harry Vardon was winning Opens back when most of us were still learning our ABCs. He's a genius in the history of our game. Mr. Vardon, I know you won this baby once before. I see your name here. It's a long time ago by the look of it. Well, we hope you boys have a nice time here in Boston. But personally, I don't think you will. I don't care if you whooped every single one of us the last 6 weeks. I'm sick and tired of people saying all you have to do to win is show up. This time, you're not taking our damn cup back.
Might just have to kill that one.
Thank you, sir. Billy, so I'll see you first thing tomorrow morning?
I can't.
Well, why not?
This English fellow offered me $20, $50 if he wins.
I can't give you anything like that.
I'm sorry, Francis. I got 2 kids at home.
Miss Campbell, I just lost my caddy. Do you know somebody you can fix me up
with? Sorry, Francis, all the lads are taken.
All of them? What am I supposed to do?
Hitch up your knickers. Do you think Vardon and Ray are going to take pity on you because you're carrying your own bag? This is the Open. Every man for himself.
What am I doing here? Hey, Francis! Jack, what are you doing here?
Me and Eddie hook school to come watch the practice round.
Oh, hey, Eddie. Hey, listen, are you still caddying out at Franklin Park?
Nah, that's right.
Is there any chance you can come over and carry for me tomorrow?
In the Open?
Yeah.
Well, what happened to your guy?
He got a better offer.
Then that guy's a big fat jerk. What?
Jack, listen, if you're going to do this, you got to be here tomorrow at 7:30 sharp.
Do it.
Can Eddie come too?
Jack, I can't change the rules. You're only allowed one man in the back. Maybe he could walk with us and keep score or something. We'll figure it out.
Francis, you got yourself a deal.
That's great, Jack. That's great. I'll see you, Eddie.
And what do you want?
I was hoping to speak to Sarah. Is she here?
She left for college.
When, today? Give her a message for me. Who was that, Freddie?
It was no one. It was a peddler.
Dad, did you hear about the caddy playing in the Open?
Which never happened. It reflects badly on all concerned.
Well, see, I say if he wants to go out and play and make a fool of himself again, so much the better.
Who are you talking about?
It's a club matter, dear.
Caddy boy. We met.
Insist he's an amateur. What is the world coming to?
More bisques, sir.
Thank you, Henry. And what kind of pie does Audrey have for us tonight?
Huckleberry, sir.
Ah, splendid.
Did you think you could keep it for me?
I didn't try to.
Your name is in the newspaper, sneaking around behind my back.
No, Father.
You're going to stop this now. A man knows his place and makes his peace with it.
I can't talk about this.
Then you listen. This is for your own good. I am trying to protect you.
Protect me from what?
Francis, those men don't have to earn a place in this world. It's given to them. We're not those kind of people. Now you go tell them that you can't do this. It's a mistake.
I won't do that.
You gave me your word. You gave me your word.
I can't quit now, I'm sorry.
This will help me when this is over. You find somewhere else to live.
Thank you.
Fine.
Make sure these people get the etiquette guide. Most of them have never been on a golf course before. God help us.
Where's Jack? I have to tee off in 10 minutes.
Truant officer caught him. He's back in school.
Well, why aren't you there with him?
Come on, this is the U.S. Open.
All right, well, thanks for coming to tell me, Eddie.
Mr. Wingett, I can caddy for you.
Eddie, my bag is as big as you are.
But I can do it. I carry for lunch at Bells at Franklin Park. Ask any of them. I came out here to make good on what Jack promised
Eddie.
You. And I hooked school, and I took 3 streetcars, okay. And I am big enough to carry that bag.
Eddie.
I'm in 5th grade, and I want to caddy
all right,
for
you. Shh, just a second. Calm down for a second. How about this? I'll carry my bag, and you can just walk next to me.
No, Mr. Wingnut.
Call me Francis.
But I can do it, Mr. Wingnut.
Francis.
I know your game. I've seen you play lots of times. I can carry that bag.
All right. All right. You can caddy for me. Okay? But you're going to have to call me Francis.
Okay, Francis.
All right.
You got a problem?
This is the 9:45 tee time. Professional from Kaniwaki Golf Club, Albert Murray. From Brookline, Massachusetts, amateur, Mr. Francis Wimet.
Side, Francis, keep your head down and I'll watch the ball. I'm gonna par this hole. That's the stuff. One shot at a time. Put and get that par. As it's steady now, make it roll, it'll sink the hole. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Supposed to miss those.
Third one this morning.
What the devil's wrong with him?
He's worried about me, sir.
Trees, you great bunch of ninnies.
Ted! Good luck, old boy. It's one of those days, what?
Still a lot of golf to play yet.
Toffee knows, Kit.
There are only two types of player. Those who keep their nerves in control and win championships, and those who do not.
President Taft.
Get out! President Taft? The United States President Taft? You ever seen a president before?
First time.
Hey! How you doing there, Mr. President?
Francis!
Did you just burn your last hole?
I guess I did, friend.
Holy smokes, Francis. You're tied with Varden. You're in second place.
I am? President Taft is talking about you. President Taft. Isn't it incredible?
Okay, we're working here, buddy. Don't listen to it, Francis. We play our game, let those guys worry about theirs.
Yeah. Francis, this is Varden in second place.
You gotta settle down now, Francis.
Yeah, how are we gonna do that?
You're just gonna have to play better. Keep your head down.
All right, give me the mashie.
You're not gonna reach your dad.
If he can, I can.
In round two, Harry Varden's pulled even with the defending champion, John McDermott. But Mr. Wilfred Reed is matching him shot for shot. After a poor showing this morning, Ted Ray's stalking the grounds like a mad brute. Mad brute. He may yet have something to say about this championship.
Easily entertained.
I'm counting on you, old boy, if Varden and that great ape of his can't deliver.
Quite. All for England?
Save that patriotic gibberish for the newspapers. The Prime Minister has promised me a seat in his cabinet if I bring back this trophy. And rest assured, Wilfred, you will be remembered.
Ah, bravo, Harry. You're tied with me for the lead.
Very well played, sir.
All for king and country, what?
Wilfred played splendidly. More than can be said for your man, Ray. Wild as a Hottentot. After his appalling first round, he won't survive the cut.
on earth are they going on about? Ted Race has broken the course scoring record.
Race time for second.
Francis.
Hey, I thought you'd gone back to college.
I thought you quit playing.
I guess I changed my mind, huh?
That's wonderful.
Yeah. It's great to see you. Can you come back tomorrow?
I have to leave tomorrow.
Come back tomorrow.
Are you his caddy? Give this to him, would you? For luck.
Dames, who needs him?
Fine play today, Mr. Weymouth.
Thank you, sir. You too. It's mostly dumb luck, though. On my part, not on your part. I mean, you don't need luck. I need luck.
Well, good luck then.
Thank you, sir.
Clean them good. Wipe the grips too.
You did just fine out there today, and
you too, Francis.
You gonna be able to skip school again tomorrow?
Let him try and stop me.
All right, well, you get home safe.
Hey, don't you worry about me. Meet you right here. Early bird gets the worm.
Deal.
I can say, ladies, is that when the day began, I scarcely imagined that I'd find myself tied for the lead with the immortal Harry Vardon, and two strokes ahead of the ever-so-capable Ted Ray.
Oh, speak of the devil and off he pops. Excuse me, ladies, I'll be with you presently. Simply adore Americans. The exuberance. Such charming naivete. How do you find them, Ted? I should imagine you feel right at home. They clasp all manner of the huddled, yearning masses to their bosoms, even the lowly golf professional. You know, I can foresee a day, given their democratic standards, when they invite your kind into their clubhouses. Well, how could they resist? Two poor lads from Jersey, up from nothing, working-class heroes to the great unwashed. And all Jersey's ever given us are potatoes and dairy cows.
Don't look over there.
Sorry, Harry, I couldn't contain myself.
No, could he?
Shouldn't have brought Jersey into it.
My God. My note. Do I look all right?
Quite frankly, Mr. Reed, it's an improvement.
So did you really see the president?
He waved at me.
No!
Yes, he did. President Taft.
Can you believe Francis? Why don't I sleep downstairs tonight?
No, I sleep upstairs. I'm okay.
Oh, Arthur!
So, they call you Mr. We Met. The others, it just says their names.
Well, Father, they're professionals. I'm an amateur.
Let's have some dessert.
Oh, wait, sit. They're all talking about you now. It say here that if you win, you get no money. The others make money, you get nothing. What does that prove? What does that prove? They don't even pay you. What kind of work is that?
Arthur,
what?
You fix your plate.
morning, Harry. Dreadful English weather.
How'd you sleep?
Like a baby. Woke up every 2 hours and cried.
If the Brits beat us, they'll say it was a fluke I ever won it. They'll say it's their game and we're not good enough. This is our open.
Wimette, O-U-I-M-E-T. He's only one stroke behind Varden and Ray after 3 rounds.
I don't want to hear how anyone else is doing, Eddie. Play our own game.
Where do we stand?
We'd still have to par the last 5 holes to tight head for the lead.
Dreadful conditions, Harry. No one would blame you if you came...
Thank you, Baron.
gun for in there. No chance he catches him now.
What's going into you, I think?
Get you going to get me angry.
Oh, yes, my mistake.
When I par this one, we'll have to go at it again tomorrow.
Playoff. What about that?
Yep, there it is.
Never seen you smoke on the job before.
Should have started four holes earlier.
Square again. Not a chance this stripling bears up.
Probably not.
We're tied and you're the one still playing.
Might as well get out of this beastly New England weather and raise a glass to British victory. What's that carrying his bag? A pygmy?
Two down. 2 down, 6 to play. I can get one here and the other 16.
That girl wanted me to give you this.
What girl?
Sarah.
Sarah gave you this?
Just put it on. Don't get all sloppy over it.
To England. What the hell was that?
It's not over yet.
What's happening?
He hit it absolutely stone dead at 16. He's only down one.
What does that mean? Is it good?
He makes this as a playoff with Barton and Ray. Dear me, it's almost beyond one's ability to calculate. Ah, don't mind if I do. He can't keep this up. It's impossible.
whole playoff tomorrow between Barton, Ray, and Mr. Wimette to decide the championship.
Boys, a gift from the gods. They're printing around the clock at home. Cripes, imagine what they're selling here. Should have bought one of these rags when I had the chance. It's a bold charge, but he's spent his powder. It's a two-man game now, my lads. An all-English final. Well, we'll see. Come on, Harry, it's inconceivable. The man's a bloody amateur. When was the last time you were beaten? Have you ever been beaten, man-to-man, in your entire career by an amateur? Amateurs do not win opens. Hell, the last one who won it back home was 40 years ago, and he was a gentleman. This one's nothing of the kind. He's a peasant. Common clay. He'll fold like an accordion.
I need my rest.
If he couldn't hit the ball a country mile, he'd be digging ditches. Where are you going, Harry? Come back, sit down with me. Eat with me. Enjoy yourself.
Let me tell you something. I came here to win a trophy. And on the face of it, Ted Ray or I should carry it off. Not for you, not for England, but for sheer bloody pride at being the best. That's why we do this. And if Mr. Wimette wins tomorrow, it's because he's the best. Because of who he is. Not who his father was, not how much money he's got. Because of who he bloody is! And I'll thank you to remember that. And I'll thank you to show the respect a gentleman gives as a matter of course. Good night.
You want him to fail. That's the only satisfaction you can take from what he's doing.
You think I want him to break his heart? What will you do, Mary, when he fails? How will you help him then? All you ever do is encourage him.
That's right. We do encourage him. He has a God-given talent, and this is his one chance to give a voice to it. He's just trying to make you proud.
It seems impossible to believe that this untested boy could hope to beat two seasoned champions. One, David, against two Goliaths. He'll have to face Varden and Ray alone, with a night to sleep on the incredible situation in which he so shockingly finds himself. Although, I suspect, from the unearthly calm he showed today, he will sleep better than most. I am not certain I believe Wimette can win. But I have given up all attempts at prophecy. I will start tomorrow's round with an open mind. It should be the greatest game ever played.
Young man, we've been talking this over.
Talking what over?
Well, the members here feel that you need as much help as you can get out there.
What kind of help is that?
According to the rules, your caddy is the only person who can give you advice. You need someone with you out there today who really knows our course. Exactly.
Well, Eddie's doing a great job for me.
Oh, for God's sake, Wimette. This is the U.S. Open, not some junior club championship.
You told Eddie this before talking to me?
Can't reason with a boy like that. We'll take up a collection for him and pay him handsomely. I understand his family could use it.
Don't let him do it, Francis. Don't let him.
Hey. Is it true? You know I can't pay you, Eddie.
I wouldn't do it for $10. I wouldn't do it for $100.
Do you think I'd replace you?
They said you'd want to.
Here's what they said. Who cares? This is me and you. We're a team. Okay? They don't get a vote in this. All right? Let's reach outside. Don't ever talk to my caddy again.
Mr. Wimmett will play first. Mr. Darwin will act as honorary marker and keep your scores. Gentlemen, it's time.
You then?
That's right.
You can do it, Princess.
What? Well, sorry, did I say something?
That was big.
They're human.
What's that?
I can play these guys, Eddie.
Yeah? Who said you couldn't?
This is where he fell apart the last time.
That was yesterday.
Supposed to be in school.
Don't be ridiculous, Father.
He's not cracking, Harry.
The thought occurred to me.
An old English final.
Come on now, finish him.
Let's see if he cracks now.
Barry!
dead in those trees.
Mid-iron. Down to you, old thing. I'm done.
Billy, it's a great match.
That's the spirit, Harry.
It's at the corner.
There's a bunker down there.
Yeah, but if he's over the bunker, he's a chip away.
We don't know he's over it. It's a trick. This is our chance, Francis. Run it in there, just like yesterday.
Thank you.
this as a one-stroke lead before the play.
This for 72. You can do it. Read it, roll it, and hold it.
Well played, Mr. Whelan. That was a great game. I enjoyed it.
So did I.
Yes, you did. Congratulations on your success. You deserve it.
Thank you.
We'll play again sometime.
Something?
Can I let you take it home with you?
Well, nobody's trying to stop me.
Well, you'd have to get past me.
You know something, Eddie? You and I are going to be great friends.
You said it, Francis.